For 125 years, Grady Hospital has served as a beacon of hope for countless people in need of health care, becoming so woven into the fabric of Atlanta that many might take it for granted. But Grady's place in our city is anything but accidental. In the latter half of the 19th century, Atlanta found itself in need of a hospital that could address the medical demands of a rapidly growing population, especially its most vulnerable. Henry Woodfin Grady, managing editor of the Atlanta Constitution, was one of the strongest advocates for a municipal hospital, often called the spokesman of the New South. Grady was a gifted public speaker who used his position to promote the idea. On June 2, 1892, that vision became a reality when Grady Hospital opened its doors with 100 beds and 18 employees named in honor of Henry Grady. And from that humble beginning, expansion came quickly, first in 1896 with the creation of the only children's ward in the state. 2 years later, Grady opened a school for nurses, followed by a school for black nurses in 1917, before the two schools ultimately merged. And in 1915, Grady became the teaching hospital for the newly formed Emory School of Medicine. With these pieces in place, the hospital began to show the nation that it would be a leader in medical treatment too. In 1921, Georgia's first open-heart surgery was performed at Grady. Just 2 years later, the Steiner Clinic, the world's first and largest comprehensive cancer center, was opened, followed by a cardiac cath lab in the 40s, one of only three in the world at the time. And through such successes, Grady continued to grow. In 1954, construction began on a new building, adding 27 floors, 1,100 beds, and 17 operating rooms. In 1984, Grady welcomed the Morehouse School of Medicine as an educational partner, making it one of only 10 teaching hospitals in the country with doctors from two medical schools. And throughout, the hospital held true to Henry Grady's vision of treating all who entered its doors. But like many safety net hospitals across the country, in time, Grady fell into financial trouble. By the mid-2000s, it was in danger of shutting its doors. That is, until community leaders in Atlanta banded together to keep Grady's lights on. And one of its most amazing recovery stories was written, that of Grady itself. The momentum of that recovery led to the creation of additional medical facilities, the Marcus Stroke and Neuroscience Center in 2010, the Marcus Trauma Center in 2011, and in 2013, the Correll Cardiac Center, all world-leading facilities. For 125 years, Grady's mission has been to teach, to lead, and to serve all in need of health care. Grady and Atlanta have evolved together, and its future is deeply rooted in this city. And so, with an eye to that future, and because of you, Grady will continue to make history and be Atlanta's very own healthcare hero.